If the radius of a beach ball is increasing at a rate of 1.5 centimeters per second, how fast is the volume changing when the radius is equal to 5 centimeters? So this is an example of a related rates problem, and you can think of this as if you were blowing up the beach ball, and as a result, the radius was increasing at 1.5 centimeters per second. And our question is, how fast is the volume changing when the radius is exactly 5 centimeters? To visualize this, we can use a Wolfram demonstration. Thinking of this sphere here as a beach ball, as we blow air into the beach ball, the radius increases, and as a result, the volume also increases. And we want to determine how fast the volume is increasing when the radius is exactly 5 centimeters. And it's increasing at 1.5 centimeters per second. So to do this, we'll have to take the derivative of the volume equation for a sphere with respects to t. So to determine this, we will have to use the volume equation for a sphere. This equation is useful when determining the volume with a given value of r, but we want to determine the rate of change of the volume with respects to time. So we'll have to differentiate both sides of this equation with respects to t. And because we're differentiating with respects to t, we will have to apply the chain rule if the term does not contain t. So the derivative of v with respects to t would be 1 times dv dt, or just dv dt. And remember, pi is a constant. So the derivative of 4/3 pi r cubed with respects to t, we would multiply by 3. That would be 4 pi r squared times dr dt. So dv dt represents the change in the volume with respects to time, and is equal to 4 times pi times r squared times dr dt, where dr dt is the rate of change of the radius with respects to time. So going back up to the original problem, when they tell us that the radius is increasing at a rate of 1.5 centimeters per second, this is telling us that dr dt, the change in the radius with respects to time, is equal to 1.5 centimeters per second. And we also want to know the change in the volume when r is equal to 5 centimeters. So now we have all the information we need to determine the change in volume with respect to time. We're going to substitute 5 for r and substitute 1.5 for dr dt. So we'll have 4 times pi times 5 squared times 1.5. So in terms of pi, we'll have 4 times 25 times 1.5, that's 150 pi, but we're measuring the change in volume with respect to time, so this would be centimeters cubed per second. Let's go ahead and get a decimal approximation for this as well. 150 times pi is approximately 471.2, this would be centimeters cubed per second. So notice how the change in volume would be affected by the radius as well as the rate of change of the radius. So this is only true when the radius is equal to 5 centimeters and when dr dt is equal to 1.5 centimeters per second. I hope you found this helpful.